Hospital of Government Services, ICT capacity building among of all Singaporeans.
Digitization of the economy and government services in all sectors is an enabler for our bottom-up economic transformation agenda. We want to run an efficient and paperless economy and society, a collaboration between Kenya and Singapore, who have a history of innovation is key, hence the inclusion of the ICT sector in our strategic partnership between our two countries. I am happy to inform you that His Excellency Long and I witnessed the signing of three memoranda of understanding on ICT, which will facilitate cooperation on cybersecurity, digitization of government services, ICT capacity building, among the other areas. We also signed another MOU on skills development to facilitate collaboration in human resource capacity building for civil servants and students, particularly in specific areas that need to support a sustainable socioeconomic development priorities, especially the ones we have identified in Kenya. As we all understand, the TVET space is the engine for providing the human capital necessary to assist us in driving our Vision 2030 and our economic development blueprint as a government. We have also agreed that the bilateral investment treaty signed between our two nations on 12th June 2018 be immediately operationalized. We further directed our respective ministers to conclude negotiations on avoidance of double taxation within the shortest time possible. And we believe this will spark and grow trade and investment opportunities between Kenya and Singapore. We have also agreed to actively explore methods of acquiring knowledge and support from Singapore's highly prosperous housing model. Kenyans are currently engaged in the housing debate, with approximately 6.5 million Kenyans lacking affordable and decent housing. Singapore has one of the most successful stories on matters of public housing. The Prime Minister has informed me that 85% of all Singaporeans live in decent, affordable public housing. Their story and journey did not start overnight. It began 60 years ago, around the same time we established our housing policy in Kenya. They took some hard decisions and made some sacrifices where they undertook mandatory savings, and the results are there for everyone to see. We are 60 years late in taking this bold step. As a result, our country is infamous for having some of the largest informal settlements that number in excess of 1,140 slums. I don't want us to postpone this agenda anymore, and thus I am asking Kenyans to make the choice by saving into the housing fund so that 60 years from now, we can also have a similar success story to tell.